This video shows how to use your digital pyrometer DP-6801 and how to assemble your ceramic thermocouple. This versatile tool is designed for precise temperature readings in various industries. It is included two types of thermocouples. One ceramic thermocouple for high temperature and also an extra fast responding thermocouple for low temperatures and testing. You need to use a correct K-type thermocouple for different range of temperatures for temperature reading accuracy. About the specification, this pyrometer has a large LCD compatible with any kind of K-type thermocouples up to 2300 Fahrenheit or 1300 Celsius. Selectable temperature readout in Fahrenheit and Celsius. Decimal point. Overload display alert for measurement beyond the range. Convenient data hold function for comparing previous temperatures. Sampling rate is 2.5 times per second, and it is powered by a standard 9-volt battery. It is behind it. You can unscrew it and open it. Now, I show to you how to assemble your ceramic thermocouple correctly. We have three parts. A thermocouple, ceramic block, and wire extension. The extension wire with red connector and thermocouple with red tube are positive poles and should be connected together and to the positive pole of your controller or thermometer. If the connections are wrong, then the reading would be off or reverse. For easy inserting the thermocouple leads to the ceramic blocks holes, loosen all the screws. Make sure the plastic shrinks covers red and black tubes are removed from the thermocouple leads before assembling. As you see, the matte one is the positive. So there is a sign on the ceramic block. This is the positive. So first, connect the extension wire, positive red. Push the tip of the connector inside the hole. Then bring it a little up. Other connector. A little up, push the lid, push the tip of the connector inside the hole, and then it's a positive match one, and inside. The lid has to connect to the connect. Now thermocouple is ready for installation. The yellow flat pin connector can use when you want to connect thermocouple to thermometer. Please consider the positive and negative pole. As you see, the small one is positive, the wider one is negative. If you don't want to use the with pyrometer, simply you can disconnect the flat pin connector and connect it directly to temperature controller. In order to get the correct reading, you need to consider 3 points. The thermocouple leads have to be in contact with the extension wire. As you see here, the connector contact with the leads. This is the correct installation. It helps the accuracy of the temperature readings. And the screws should be tightened firmly. You can check the pictures in the manual too. These two, and these two. At least 2/3 of the length of the thermocouple has to be placed in your kiln. Also consider to make a suitable hole for thermocouple or ceramic protection tube, like this. As you see, there is a hole inside it. Thermocouple going inside it, and it protect your ceramic thermocouple, the ceramic protection tube. Please consider to make a suitable hole for thermocouple or ceramic protection tube. Making a big hole opening in your kiln can lead to the melting of the thermocouple connectors. So the big hole is gonna be transfer heat around of the thermocouple and melt all the wires and protections over there. You need to place the thermocouple tip exactly where you need to measure the temperature. Ceramic insulators on the thermocouple separates thermocouple lead legs for an accurate temperature reading. To prevent a breakage of your insulators, avoid sudden temperature changing. So put your thermocouple before you start your kiln. Handle with care during installation and removal and minimize vibration. Use ceramic protection tube will protect the thermocouple from chemical reactions, abrasion, impact damage, or thermal shock. On thermomart.com, you will find all kinds of pyrometers, thermocouples, temperature controllers, and more. Please check the description for links.